CTV News at 5 with Hudson Mack.
Well, Victoria, bookworms were getting a little wet today after the public library branch downtown was hit by a flood. A pipe burst in the government offices on the third floor, and that sent water gushing down onto the shelves filled with library books on the floor below. Staff was able to get plastic over them, minimize the damage, and clean up in time to reopen this afternoon.
There's a process, and thank goodness we had a collection disaster plan, so we were able to put that in place. Now it's the first time we've had something quite this extensive, so it is a learning experience for us, but we have great assistants, have some conservators that are helping us and giving us advice.
The library says it'll take a few more days for the area to dry out. Some areas will be inaccessible, but says it'll return to regular hours tomorrow. They will freeze dry the books that are got wet to try to restore them and minimize the damage. And the Nanaimo family is asking for your help tonight. They're trying to find closure in a 7-year-old missing persons case. Eric Brett was 50 years old when he disappeared on December 21st, 2005. Brett was a mental health patient at Nanaimo Regional General Hospital. He walked out of the hospital on his own and never returned. A healthcare worker spotted him a few days later near the Port Place Mall, but that was the last time he was seen. Eric Brett is 6'3", about 200 pounds, and wears glasses. Police say his family is desperately looking for him or for closure. If you have any information on his disappearance, you're asked to contact RCMP in Nanaimo or Crime Stoppers. Well, today is World Kidney Day, and a group of Vancouver Islanders is taking the necessary steps to try to stop kidney disease in its tracks, getting you to sign up to be an organ donor. The Kidney Foundation of Canada wants you to know that by signing an organ donation card, you can simply save a life. The group of donors, transplant recipients, and volunteers took to the streets with a banner today, pounding the pavement around Royal Jubilee Hospital to get their message across. It's an uphill trek, though. 85% of British Columbians say they want to donate an organ, but only 19% of us have registered to do it. The Kidney Foundation says that gap is a death sentence for the 2,800 people on kidney dialysis in BC who are waiting up to 5 years for a transplant.
Well, we're trying to raise awareness for kidney health and just getting words out about transplant and how important it is, how important because you can save a life by donating and being on that transplant list.
People need to get out there, they need to be aware, they need to, you know, get online, sign to be a registered donor. There's too many people sitting there waiting for kidneys, and not everybody is fortunate enough to have a living donor.
The Victoria chapter of the Kidney Foundation is also looking for a donation of your time. It needs volunteers to help put on this year's Kidney Walk, which is August 18th at Clover Point. A Cowichan Valley physiotherapist accused of sexually assaulting patients will have his court case delayed because he cannot afford a lawyer. A judge has issued a temporary stay of proceedings. In the case against Campbell Crichton of Duncan, he faces 23 counts of sexual assault. Prosecutors argued he has no right to a lawyer funded by taxpayers because he made poor financial choices and did not prioritize his spending for the defense. But the judge says that Crichton has proven he is broke. No indication when the proceedings against him will proceed. The city of Nanaimo wants your feedback on a pilot project which would allow dogs to go off-leash in selected parks. There are currently 8 off-leash parks in Nanaimo, 4 more pilot locations in the works. Last night, the city held a public feedback session to find out what's working and what's not.
We're always looking for new areas, or do we have the right areas? We're trying to cover the city in general. We're trying to address issues like access to water. That's been a common concern. So, I think it's very important that people tell us what parts of the city they're from and where they'd like to see dog off-leash parks.
The city has hosted 5 open houses for off-leash feedback over the past few years. If you couldn't make the session last night, you have till April 1st to get your feedback in online at nanaimo.ca.